湾公广集团。华视教育文化频道。
您现在收看的是华视教育文化频道。
接下来要播出的是商用英语绘画下。
Back. I'm your teacher Lisa, and our foreign teacher Lin is here with us today. Hi, Lin.
Hi, Lisa, and hi to you all. In our last lesson, we learned how to make a conversation go further by talking about hobbies. You can ask questions like, "What do you like to do in your free time?" Or, "What kind of hobbies and interests do you have?" Or even, "What kind of things are you interested in?" You can also learn to talk about your own hobbies by saying, I love aerobics, or I really like swimming.
You know, Lin, you know, people love to talk about things they are interested in. Mm-hmm. So by doing this, by asking their hobbies or answer their questions, that can really help you to lead intothe conversation mm-hmm. that both will feel comfortable, right?
Right.
Uh-huh. And today we are going to move on to a new unit, a new chapter. It's about dining out, okay? So, well, before we get into our lesson, let's check our chapter focus first. Here we go, chapter focus.
Our first chapter focus is to learn the language used as a restaurant greeter.
今天学习的第一个重点就是在餐厅里头的这个打招呼的人哈，就是接待人员该会用的言语。
Our second focus is to learn the language used as a customer.
在餐厅里头，如果你是一个顾客，那么会有一些顾客应该会用到的语言。
And to learn the appropriate expressions used to decide who pays the bill.
学习的第三个重点就是如果谁要付账单，怎么这些话要怎么来表达，这将是我们学习的重点。
Lisa, what kind of cuisine do you prefer?
I prefer Italian cuisine, because I love the way they cook. It's healthier this way. What about you?
Well, I kind of like spicy food, Lisa, so I'd have to say Mexican cuisine.
Okay, we just use the word cuisine. Okay, 就是所谓的料理哈。我喜欢意大利的料理，另喜欢 spicy cuisine, like Mexican food, 墨西哥的食物。Maybe Lin can give a detailed explanation on this keyword.
Well, it's just a particular kind of food known to maybe a particular...place or a particular country.
Yeah, 就是特别属于某个国家的料理或某种食物的烹调法，这个就是 cuisine. Well, what about give our student one example?
Sure. This restaurant is known for its Taiwan cuisine.
Okay, 这个饭店呢，餐厅是台湾的料理闻名的哈，有名的。Well, right now we're moving to first conversation, and in this conversation, you will see a customer just arrived at the restaurant, and is met by the greeter. They are talking about the reservation. Here we go, conversation one.
Welcome to Cocktail Cuisine. Do you have a reservation?
Yes, I called and made a reservation for tonight.
What is the name, please?
The reservation is under the name of Creighton.
Creighton. Yes, I see it here. You have a reservation for a party of three. We were expecting you at 6:30. I'm afraid your table's not quite ready.
Yes, I know. I'm a little early.
Could you wait for a moment to be seated?
Oh, no hurry. I don't mind waiting. The rest of my party hasn't arrived yet anyway.
I understand. I could give you a booth now in the smoking area. But I see you requested a table in the non-smoking area.
I think I'd rather wait.
Then please take a seat in the waiting area. And I'll call you as soon as your table is ready. Sir, I'll show you to your table now. Sorry to have kept you waiting. Please follow me.
Actually, I'd prefer a table by the window, if one's available.
We are really busy tonight. You might have to wait another 10 minutes for a table by the window. I'm so sorry.
That's okay. Whatever you have now is fine. Could you show my friends to this table when they arrive?
Of course. Your waitress will be with you in a minute.
Lynn, people who are from the Netherlands, we call them Dutch. But what about when we say, go Dutch? What does that really mean by that?
Well, it has nothing to do with the Netherlands, Lisa. It has to do with each person paying for everything themselves, paying their own way.
Okay. 同学们知道啊，如果是啊荷兰人，我们荷兰人，我们说他是一个 Dutch， 啊，就是荷兰人叫做 Dutch。那常常在啊用餐的时候，或者是付账的时候，我们会说 Okay, go Dutch。意思就是各付各的，叫 go Dutch。Well, give our students one example before we move on.
To go Dutch, okay? Why don't we go Dutch?You paid for everything last week.
Okay, why don't we go Dutch? 我们今天就各付各的吧。You pay for everything last week. 你上周都是你付的哈。所以这个叫做 go Dutch。记住那个 Dutch 要大写，因为这个字本身就是指荷兰人。但是 go Dutch 跟荷兰人没有关系，意思就是各付各的账单。
So Lisa, another expression to go.That means the same as to go Dutch, means to split the bill. You can say to split the bill or go Dutch.
Okay, 还有林老师说了，除了 go Dutch 是各付各的，还有一个同样的表达法叫做 split the bill. Bill, 把它分一半，意思就是各付各的。
Let me give an example, Lisa.
All right.
It isn't fair to split the bill this time. My daughter is eating with us today.
Okay.这次各付各的不太公平，因为我的女儿跟我一起用餐。It isn't fair to split the bill. Like this, since my daughter is eating with us today. Okay, so Lynn, go Dutch and split the bill means you share the expense or you pay your own part. What do we say if we are going to treat someone? We're going to pay for others.
Well, just what you said, Lisa, it's my treat.
My treat, 意思就是这次我来付钱。
Or I'm treating today.
I'm treating today. 我今天付帮你付。
Or you can say it's on me.
It's on me. 这次是我来付账单。这些是刚刚说的是各付各的。那现在新谈的 it's my treat. It's on me. 这个就是我请客的意思了哈。
It means when you pay for something for someone else.
All right. It's my treat. You are visiting me, my hometown. So, Lynn, it's my treat. So,
Thank
what
you,
would you like to eat? It will be on me tonight. Okay. So, 刚刚说的就是这是我来付账，或者是 it's on me.
So, when we say it's on somebody or someone, it's paid by someone.
Okay. It's on someone, 就是如果老板跟你出去吃饭，老板说 "It's on me"， 或者是你说 "It's on my boss"， 意思就是老板付账了哈。It's on 是介系词，你都认识这个字，但是在这个 special situation 用法是不一样，解释也是不一样的。
So I'll give another example, okay?
All right.
Please don't consider the price. The meal is on me.
All right. 别担心，别考虑价钱，这次是我买单。意思是这样子。Okay, right now let's move on to our conversation too. Two colleagues are having lunch at the sit-down restaurant, and they will talk about those keywords we just talked. Okay, here we go, conversation two.
The food here is really good. I especially like the bread.
It seems like everyone's enjoying it. Glad they're bringing some more.
Jim, after you take some bread, could you pass it to me?
Sure.
And while you're at it, could you pass the butter as well, please?
Here it is. Don't you think the lasagna is a little bland?
Not for me. I don't like spicy food.
It seems it needs a little something. Could you pass the salt and pepper?
There you go.
May I have the check, please?
Why don't we split the bill?
Go Dutch? Not this time. I invited you to lunch. This will be my treat.
Thank you. The next time, it will be on me.
It's a deal.
A party of three.
A group of people who are going somewhere or who are all involved in the same activities.
I'm sorry, this table has been reserved for a party of seven.
抱歉，这桌已被七个人给预定走了。
Be seated.
Used for politely asking someone to sit down or to sit down.
Would you like to be seated upstairs or downstairs?
你要坐在楼上呢，还是楼下？
Booth.
A table in a restaurant enclosed by two long seats with high backs.
Would you like to sit in a booth or a table?
你要坐在一般的沙发坐上，还是一般的桌？
Would rather.
Used for saying that you would prefer to do something, or that you would prefer that something happen.
I'd rather sit in a booth than at a table, if you don't mind.
如果你不介意，我宁可坐有高椅背的桌子，而不是一般的桌子。
While you're at it.
Asking someone to do a second thing before the first action is finished.
Bring me the dictionary on the table, and while you're at it, bring me a pen as well.
把我桌上的字典带来，顺便也将我的笔拿来。
Lasagna.
An Italian meal made with the layers of flat pasta.With the sauce, cheese, and meat or vegetables.
Would you like your lasagna with or without extra cheese?
你的意大利面要多加或不多加 cheese?
Bland.
Not having a strong taste and therefore not very interesting to eat.
Since his heart attack,He has had to eat mostly bland foods.
因为他的心脏病，他必须吃得很清淡。
Needs a little something.
It seems incomplete or missing something.
This steak needs a little something. Could you pass me the salt?
这牛排需要一点味道，可以把盐传给我吗？Okay, right now we're going to repeat these keywords with the Chinese translation. Here we go.
A party of three.
一团、一群或一组。
The party of 12 toured Europe together.
一群十二人一起去欧洲旅游。
Be seated.
请就坐。
Waiting to be seated can take a lot of time.It saves time to make a reservation.
等位子要花许多的时间，如果能够先预约，可以节省时间。
Booth.
雅座或者是隔间的座位通常有高的椅背。
There are more booths than tables in most fast food restaurants.
大部分的快餐店有比较多这样子有高椅背的这种桌子。
Would rather.
宁愿较喜欢。
I'd rather eat Mexican food than Chinese tonight if it's okay with you.
如果可以的话， 我今晚宁可吃墨西哥菜而不是中国菜。
While you are at it,
反正你已经要去了，那就顺便再做另外一件事。
All right, I'll be A, you be B, Lisa. Here we go.
Okay.
I'm going to the grocery store to get some milk.
While you are at it, could you pick up some bread? 这个意思就是，反正你要去杂货店，那顺便再帮我买一些面包回来。他说他要去买牛奶，我说顺，反正你要去了，那你顺便帮我带面包回来。 While you are at it. Okay, next one.
Lasagna.
Lasagna 是一个意大利的一种宽的面条，它加上一层一层的酱料、肉末跟奶、cheese 在上边。Lasagna
is a very filling food.
意大利面是让人很饱的食物。Bland, 清淡无味。Most
hospital food is bland.
大部分医院的食物都很清淡无味。Needs
a little something.
少点什么。I
don't know what's wrong with this food, but it needs a little something, don't you think?
我不知道这道菜怎么了，但是它好像少了什么东西，你觉得呢？ Needs a little something, 需要一些东西，意思就是少了点什么。 All right, that's key words and phrases. Right now we have situations we're going to share with you more about the conversation in different situations. Here we go, situations.
Today in our first situation, we're going to talk about some language we would use when you first arrive at a restaurant. Later we'll talk about, in the second situation, about language we'd use once we sit down at the restaurant. You know, dining out in a formal situation, you need a reservation. Mm-hmm. And the following questions will help you as the greeter to ask those questions that are needed. And then we'll have some answers that the person would need as a customer to answer those questions.
Okay, 谢谢林老师。他刚说了，今天我们要学有两个 situation. 第一个 situation 就是你在餐厅里头，你需要跟餐厅里头的人所产生的对话，比如说订预约等等。第二个 conversation 就是在餐桌上，同学们有时候在商场上，你跟人家吃饭的时候，餐桌上西式的餐桌的 一些可能会产生的对话，我们待会会带你们一起来学习。现在我们来看第一个 situation 是 greeter 跟 customer 的对话。我们来看。Do you have a reservation?
Yes, we do. We have a reservation for a party of six.
第一个进入餐厅，你会被问的就是 Do you have a reservation? 通常一般 sit down the restaurant 他要求你是要先 reservation 就是要订预约。他说 Yes, we do. We have a reservation for a party of six. 一群六个人的已经订好约了。下一个 How many people in your party?
Three.
这个多少人在 in your party 这个字，同学不会误会了哈，不是这个一般你们知道的 party， 这个就是指这一群人有这一群一团有多少人 ？Okay, next one. What time do you want your reservation for?
At six.
你已经订约了哈，人家就会问你 What time do you want your reservation for? 你要几点啊 ？Next one. What is the name, please?
White, Betty White.
Okay, 订约的时候在也要给人家名字哈。 What is the name, please? 你就告诉人家姓 White. 我姓白，然后我的名字叫 Betty White. Next one. Would you like smoking or non-smoking?
Non-smoking, please.
Okay, would you like smoking or non-smoking? 订约的时候，可能这个问题很简单，就问人家吸烟区或非吸烟区。Could you wait a moment to be seated? Or you can say, please wait to be seated. 这两句都是请你等位置的意思。那你的回应可以是
Okay.
Okay, the last one is, I'll show you to your table. 或者是 please follow me.
Thank you.
在这里就是说到这个 greeter 把你带位到你的桌，你定还要引你进入到你的餐桌，或者是你他就很简单说 please follow me， 你就跟着他，他会引你进入。OK， 这是第一个 situation 哈、啊，就是 greeter 跟 customer 的对话。接下去我们的 situation two is about the conversation at the table。You know, the situation, the dining custom is very different between Chinese meal and American Western meal, American style meal. So, 很多时候是要 pass 东西，因为他们吃饭的那个习惯是不一样。现在我们来看有哪些在餐桌上可以产生的对话。
Can you pass me the pepper?
Sure.OK， 他们在餐桌用餐的时候，常常桌上就是有胡椒跟那个胡椒粉跟盐。这时候你总是我们的习惯就自己拿，但是西方要用 pass me the pepper。Can you pass me the pepper?
May I have the bread?
There you go. OK， 吃饭的时候有他们常常是主餐是面包，这时候你也是不能够就自己拿，要叫人家传给你，除非那个东西看靠近你，你可以，不然的话，你就是要请人家递过来，因为这个是 polite way to do so. May I have the bread? There you go, 人家就会传给你哈。
Pass me the butter, please.
Here it is. Okay, pass me the butter. Okay, 传奶油给我，这也是他们像 butter, pepper, salt.Bread 都是在这个西式食物里头都会这样子放在桌上让你传的了哈。OK， 接下去我们要看另外一个情况，就是 when you pay the bill， 当你带外国客户出去吃饭的时候，当付账的时候，那一刻有哪些语言会产生呢 ？Ways to pay the bill， 我们来看有哪些。
May I have the check, please? Shall we split the bill?
OK， 付账的时候你就说我可不可以我来付账，你就可以说check 给我，这个 check 不是支票，就是指这个用餐的这个要付账的账单哈，或者是你就可以直接说 shall we split the bill， 我们可不可以各付各的。还有呢，
I'm paying please I insist I'll take care of the check this time
同学们，你看到这三句都是在要付账的时候，有时候大家就争着要谁付，要谁付。这个这几句就是你可以说的 ，I'm paying， 啊，我付账，或者是 Please I insist， 我坚持，坚持什么？坚持付账的意思哈，或者是 I'll take care of the check this time， 这次账单由我来付啊。这三句都是在要付账单的时候很好。表达的一个句子，如果你要付账啊
，Let's go Dutch. Let's go halves. It's on me. This will be my treat.
同学们，前两句就是各付各的 ，Let's go Dutch， 或者是 Let's go halves， 我们分各分一半。后两句呢，就是指你要买单哈 ，This is on me， 这次由我来付账，或者是 This will be my treat。这次由我来请客。All right, right now it's time I'm going to replay the conversation one and two together for you. Okay, here we go. Conversation one and two.
Welcome to Cocktail Cuisine. Do you have a reservation?
Yes, I called and made a reservation for tonight.
What is the name, please?
The reservation is under the name of Creighton.
Creighton.Yes, I see it here. You have a reservation for a party of three. We were expecting you at 6:30. I'm afraid your table's not quite ready.
Yes, I know. I'm a little early.
Could you wait for a moment to be seated?
Oh, no hurry. I don't mind waiting. The rest of my party hasn't arrived yet anyway.
I understand. I could give you a booth now in the smoking area. But I see you requested a table in the non-smoking area.
I think I'd rather wait.
Then please take a seat in the waiting area.And I'll call you as soon as your table is ready. Sir, I'll show you to your table now. Sorry to have kept you waiting. Please follow me.
Actually, I'd prefer a table by the window, if one's available.
We are really busy tonight. You might have to wait another 10 minutes for a table by the window. I'm so sorry.
That's okay. Whatever you have now is fine. Could you show my friends to this table when they arrive?
Of course. Your waitress will be with you in a minute.
The food here is really good. I especially like the bread.
It seems like everyone's enjoying it. Glad they're bringing some more.
Jim, after you take some bread, could you pass it to me?
Sure.
And while you're at it, could you pass the butter as well, please?
Here it is. Don't you think the lasagna is a little bland?
Not for me. I don't like spicy food.
It seems it needs a little something. Could you pass the salt and pepper?
There you go.
May I have the check, please?
Why don't we split the bill?
Go Dutch? Not this time. I invited you to lunch. This will be my treat.
Thank you. The next time, it will be on me.
It's a deal.
A reservation?
Yes, it's under my name, Lynn Condren.
How many people will be in your party?
There will be four.
Would you like smoking or non-smoking?
Non-smoking.
Could you wait a moment to be seated?
All right.
Can I have a booth?
I'm afraid there isn't any available now.
May I have the check, please?
I'll bring it right away.
This lasagna needs a little something. Pass salt and pepper, please.
There you go.
All right, 同学，我们刚刚所进行的是 Your Turn。在你的词教科书上，老师把这整单元里头觉得是对同学最能够很快能够使用哈，把它放在一起，所以同学们可以做练习。刚刚有几个字，老师在这边顺便解释一下哈，就是一个那个 booth， 这也是今天的生字之一。当你在用餐的时候，老师就特别要问人家说，在餐厅里头有那种椅子，就是一般的桌子的椅子，这个叫 table。还有一个总桌子，就是有那种沙发，有那种就是沙发，你知道哈，背后边有沙发的那种在国外。这种位置叫做 booth， 那通常这个 booth 呢，通常就是有隔间会隔起来。如果你查生字的话，可能这个叫做雅座。但是老师也有问这个台湾人到底用什么字来描述这种 booth， 这类的 table， 他们说就叫做沙发椅。OK， 但是当我们用沙发椅的时候，也不尽然啊。然后同学们又想到是一般的沙发哈。But anyway, just give you an idea. There's two different kinds of table when you go dining in a Western restaurant. All right, dining out with your foreign guests is so common in the business field. I hope today's lesson will be helpful and useful for you.
Yesterday, we learned language used as a restaurant greeter and as a customer in a restaurant. There's many things that we might ask, like, would you like a table or a booth? Or you might ask questions about who pays for the bill, like, well, let's split the bill, or it's on me.
All right, students, we have more to learn. When you come back next week, we're going to continue to learn some languages that used at the restaurant. I hope that you'll be back on time and have a wonderful day today when you go to work. Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.